going to revise the first chapter, chemical reactions and chemical equations. So chemical reaction is something when we allow any reactant to undergo change, like we burn paper. So paper on burning in presence of air, it forms CO2, moisture and other materials like, you know, heat or flame, etc. So if you write like this paper, this, so simply we write C, carbon from any source plus O2 and gives rise to CO2 plus water plus heat. So this chemical equation is the symbolic representation of a chemical reaction. Chemical reactions are the changes when one substance changes to other. So it is chemical reactions and chemical equations. Then there is unbalanced equation. Unbalanced equation is also called as skeletal. It is also called as skeletal equation. A skeletal equation means when any reaction is not, any equation is not balanced, it is called as a skeletal equation, a skeletal or unbalanced. See, in this side there are the reactants, and this side there are the products. So when the number of atoms are not same inside of reactants as well as inside of the products, it is called as unbalanced. So this is one that is unbalanced. Second is balanced equation. Balanced equation means when the species, they are constant, species are equal, number of atoms are equal in both the sides. See here there is one carbon, here carbon is one, oxygen is two, here oxygen is how much? 2 plus 1, 3. But here hydrogen 2, here there is no hydrogen. So we can say that this equation is unbalanced, or this is said to be a skeletal. Now I am writing another example of balanced equation. See, N2 plus S2, N2 nitrogen, S2 hydrogen. They react together and there is formation of ammonia, NH3, it is ammonia. Now see, this is also unbalanced. Nitrogen is 2 here nitrogen is 1, here hydrogen is 2, here hydrogen is 3. So as you know, I have explained about the balancing of equation in the month of April. So here we put the stoichiometric coefficient in suitable number. So here 2. So here nitrogen is 2, we simply put here 2. So here nitrogen is 2, now we have balanced equation and nitrogen is 2 also. But here, see, hydrogen 3 into 2, it becomes 6. Here it is 2 only. So simply we put here 3. So this is the balancing. Balancing of equation can be done by several methods, and this method is called as heat and trial. This is called as heat and trial method. Hit means strike, and so ultimately we balance. So keep in mind, during the balancing of equation, we select the lowest integer as far as possible, one point. And second point is, the suitable integer is always prefixed. It has to be kept clear, and so it is said to be the this. Now, it can never be inside. It can never be inside any species. We can look right here. Ultimately, so this is the heat and trial method. Now coming to the type of chemical reactions. Chemical reactions are of different types. Chemical reactions, classification, types. First is combination. So in combination reaction, two or more species are joined together. two or more species are joined together under suitable condition to form some bigger molecule like hydrogen and oxygen. They on burning or in presence of electric spark, there is formation of H2. Again, see the equation is not balanced. What we do? We put here 2, and so here it becomes 4. Now we have balanced oxygen. Now, so this is the way how to balance. So this is one combination reaction. Now, second is decomposition. Decomposition reaction. So decomposition is just opposite of combination. In combination, we join to a smaller to form a bigger. But in decomposition, a bigger species, a bigger molecule is broken down. So it requires energy also. So decomposition is of three types. It is of three types. First is thermal. Second is electrical. And third is photochemical. Thermal decomposition, electrical decomposition, and photochemical decomposition. Now, thermal takes place by heating. Electrical takes place by passing current, and it takes place in presence of sunlight. In presence of sunlight or light. Now see the specific examples. Like when we take calcium carbonate, this is limestone. So limestone on strong heating, it undergoes decomposition. So calcium oxide, this is peat lime. And CO2 gas. So this reaction is said to be thermal decomposition. So any reaction when takes place by heating, it is said to be thermal decomposition. Now coming to second, water. We take the acidic water. Acidic means little amount of acid has been added to make it conducting, because water is basically bad conductor in pure form. So we make it acidic. Little amount of salt can be added, little amount of base can be added. So on passing electric current, there is formation of H2 and O2. Here we draw arrow mark also. Now there is one point some of you asked that we have to write compulsory. No, the state of the retention products is not necessarily written unless until it is asked. It is basically beginning of your science or chemistry, and so we generally not write in higher classes. Just in small classes we write, just by indicating, so you can know the basics. So it is not necessary to mention the state of the retained salt products. So this is acidic. Now this is said to be electrolysis. Electrolysis means the breaking of any molecule by passing current. Electro means current, lysis means to break, electrolysis. So it is electrolysis. Now coming to photochemical decomposition. So photochemical decomposition means the substances, the salts which are decomposed in presence of sunlight or ordinary light. Like see, this is silver bromide in presence of light or sunlight, there is formation of metallic silver and this gas. Again, we balance here. So this is heat and trial method. Now, silver bromide, all the salts of silver, all silver salts, they exhibit photochemical reaction. Silver salt, bromide, silver iodide, silver nitrate also. And here, there is the gray colored solid deposited. So this is all about the decomposition reaction. Then third is displacement reaction. So displacement, there is the change in the species. So displacement, it is of two types, single displacement, only one species is displaced. Like we take the case of copper sulfate aqueous. In copper sulfate aqueous, we put an iron nail and there is the formation of FeO4 aqueous and plus copper solid. So this has blue color, iron has gray color, it has light green color, and it has brown color. Now this reaction is based on the difference in the reactivity. See what has happened. Iron has displaced copper. So one species has displaced other, and so this copper has been removed from this. So this is said to be the single displacement reaction. Now coming to double displacement means when two species are displaced by each other. Like we take the case of silver nitrate aqueous. This is silver nitrate, and we put sodium chloride solution. So there is reaction, and here there is formation of silver chloride solid. This is silver chloride, and NaNO3 aqueous. This is colorless. And silver chloride here, it is solid, and it is in form of white precipitate. It is in form of white precipitate. And so see, this sodium has displaced silver, and silver has in place of sodium. So both have displaced each other, and so this reaction is said to be double displacement. Now keep in mind that always more reactive metals displaces least reactive. More reactive displaces least reactive, or we can say that sodium is more reactive than Cl, iron is more reactive than copper. So this is about the displacement reaction. Now coming to oxidation, and on this side there is reaction. Oxidation is simply addition of oxygen or addition of electronegative elements like chlorine, etc., or removal of hydrogen, or removal of electropositive element. So this is the oxidation. Now reduction is just opposite of oxidation. So here there is addition hydrogen or addition of electro positive element, removal of oxygen or removal of electro negative element. So they are just opposite to each other. Oxidation and reduction, they are just opposite to each other. Now see, for example, here hydrogen and oxygen on burning, they form water. So here, this is very interesting to note. Oxygen has deactivated hydrogen. So this is oxidation. This is oxidation. So here you say oxidation of hydrogen to form water. Addition of oxygen to hydrogen is oxidation. Similarly, hydrogen has been added to oxygen. So reduction of O2. And so there. So one point I have given you in the beginning of the session, oxidation and reduction are said to be complementary of each other. Oxidation and reduction are said to be complementary to each other. Complementary to each other means they complement each other. One cannot take place in absence of other. Once again, I'm repeating, oxidation and reduction are said to be complementary to each other because neither oxidation can take place on its own, nor reduction can take place. They go side by side. If one species undergoes oxidation, other must undergo reduction. Now, then there is the oxidant or oxidizing agent and reductant or reducing agent. So oxidizing agents or oxidant, reducing agents or reductants. So oxidants are the species which cause oxidation. Reductants causes reduction. Now oxidants are like HNO3, KNO4, K2, Cr2O7. They are oxidizing agents. Reducing agents are lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, hydrogen and zinc. So in coupling they take. So this is about the oxidizing agents and reducing agents. And last part of this video, I'm going to tell about some two points. And the points are, number one is rancidity. So rancidity is the development of foul smell. Development of bad smell or foul smell or unpleasant smell in food materials containing oil and fat due to slow oxidation. Like you must be knowing, when we keep something like pickles or a namkeen like matri or any sweet containing oil for longer time period, say they develop some smell, unpleasant smell, and so we say that it has become rancid. You must be knowing, you must have seen all the brand new food materials, it is written a particular date that this thing has to be consumed within a prescribed time period. So this is rancidity. So for this rancidity, we add, to prevent rancidity, we add antioxidants. We add antioxidants, we keep in excess of nitrogen and we keep at low temperature we keep in air tight container. So this is about the rancidity. Now last part is corrosion. Corrosion, you must be knowing. Corrosion is eating away, of metals. Metals they undergo degradation, metals undergo change like rusting. So corrosion is an electrochemical process. It is an electrochemical process. And so factors affecting are CO2, moisture, oxygen, and impurities. So four factors, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the four factors for corrosion. Example of corrosion: rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver. Rusting of iron, rust is Fe2O3XH2O. X is number of water molecules. This depends on the atmospheric condition. Nowadays we have the rainy season, so here in case of rusted objects, weight is more. So the quantity of X is variable. Number of water molecules is one point, which you will see in the third chapter. So rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver. So this is the formula of rust. And in tarnishing of silver, silver objects becomes black. There is formation of silver sulfide. So this is the chemical substance formed. Now how we prevent corrosion? So corrosion can be prevented by different conditions. First, like you must be knowing, galvanization. So galvanization is done for the iron only. Iron objects to be prevented from the corrosion, they are dipped into molten zinc. So galvanization is done for the zinc. Zinc is taken because zinc is more active, zinc is present on the surface, and as a result it undergoes oxidation and prevent the iron. Then keeping away from air or oxygen. So by we apply paint, we apply oil, we make alloy, keeping metal in pure state. So these are the four important points. Painting, we apply paint. So what happens by painting? The metal layer is cut off from the air. Then we apply oil or grease, so there is the formation of thin layer, so layer prevents. Then alloy, we must know alloy. Alloy is mixture of two or more metals, or metal and some non-metal. So alloy, steel. Steel is an alloy. Brass, bronze, they are stable than their components. So metals in pure state, you must know, pure metals do not undergo corrosion. Like you must know, the ornaments which are pure ornaments, coins of silver and gold, so they are stable because they are in pure form.